What is up, YouTube? This is Trainer Connor, and I am here with another Showdown Wi-Fi battle video. Thank you guys for coming. Make sure you leave a like and subscribe for more videos. A few days ago, my YouTube channel hit 5 years, which is amazing. 2012 to the present, 2017, that is, and I gotta say, you know, the beginning was kind of a flip-flop, I guess, because I was recording with a 3DS at the time, and then I got a camcorder, and my narrations were pretty good at the beginning, and then I kind of slowed down on that, and I wanted to improve on it some more, and then we are here. So, awesome. I will continue making videos. Why not, right? Because it's the future. I'm in college. A brand new beginning. That's not going to stop me from making videos, after all. But right now, I am in this situation where I have to continue making Showdown battles because I don't have time to play my DS and everything. I will get access to Homebrew this week because I heard that 11.5 Homebrew is out. So if you want to generate Pokemon for breeding, or to help you breed, I guess. In this case, I will probably do that. Otherwise, I'll just generate Pokemon for fun. I'll import the sets that I have here onto my game, so it's easier. And yeah, I'll continue making Wi-Fi battles in Sun and Moon, and then Ultra Sun and Moon. Anyways, though, we have a new team. UU is the clear today, Underused. Underused has a lot of stuff, so let's get to it. We have Legion, the Chandelure, holding the leftovers with the ability Flash Fire, Flamethrower, or actually Calm Mind first, and then Flamethrower, Shadow Ball, and Pain Split. And the idea for this set is you go for Calm Mind, and you're pretty bulky in general, so because my EV spread is max HP and everything. So basically, you survive a hit, you go for Calm Mind, and then you go for Flamethrower or Shadow Ball. Otherwise, you go first, you go for Calm Mind, and then you take a hit a lot better. And then you just go for Flamethrower or Shadow Ball for damage outputs. And then you go for Pain Split for HP as well. Awesome. Secondarily, we have Humpback, the Hippowdon. He's going to be an interesting Hippowdon, holding the Assault Vest. And the idea for that is you have all attacking moves, max HP and max attack, for his special defense. He already has good defense already, even without investment, so going for the Assault Vest set on Hippowdon is actually working out here. Earthquake, Fire Fang, Iron Head, and Stone Edge are the moves for this guy right here. It has a lot of coverage here, obviously, with fire, steel, and rock. It's gonna hit a lot of things in the UU tier. Most notably, I will not hit a lot of water types, but I wouldn't want to stay in on a like a Blastoise or a Mega Sharpedo or something like that. But you know, that's what you're supposed to do. If you're in that situation, you can always switch out. So next up we have Vulture, the Mangabuzz, Leftovers, yet again. And wow, I'm looking at the level. I thought it said 180, but I don't have my glasses on, so it's kind of weird seeing it, but it's a level 100, so anyway, Leftovers on Vulture, that's level 100. Mangabuzz is going to be, he's going to be a defensive Pokemon here. Defog, Foul Play, Roost, and Knock Off. Max HP, max defense. So, combine Mangabuzz and Hippowdon. Yes, their sets are kind of flip-flopped because Mangabuzz has a lot more special defense and then Hippowdon has a lot more physical defense. I kind of like alternate the EV spread, which is kind of weird in my opinion, but I'll make it work. I promise you. Snowball is our Ninetales in Alola form. She's going to be holding the Lumberry, Snow Cloak, Ice Beam, Psyshock, Shock, Hidden Power Fire, and Moonblast. Pretty interesting set. It's pretty standard, actually, but, you know, moves like Ice Beam and Psyshock and Hidden Power Fire are moves that you don't normally, I guess you don't see very often. I don't know. I haven't really used Ninetales that much. That might be the standard set. I don't know. But it should be fun to use. We'll see Snowball doing some action in the spell video. We have Shell Shock, the Chloe Search was banded, Explosion, Ice Shard, Razor Shell, and Poison Jab. I put a lot of HP in there. You see that? I decided to make him bulky. Over speed, he's not that fast. So why put him in that situation? Besides, I already have Ice Shard to priority. So if I really need to outspeed something, I can use Ice Shard anyway. Plus, you know, I'm bulky. I can take a hit and I can go for explosion and everything. So, wow, my mouse is kind of acting weird. But anyway, Hoopa is my last Pokemon. And he is also holding the Assault Vest. What the hell? Alright, we're going to change that. So, we'll make him Life Orb. Why not? I don't want to alternate or keep the same item for every Pokemon, but that should be it. Yeah, that should be good. So we'll save that and go all the way to the bottom again. Alright, awesome. So Life Orb, Hoopa, Magician, Drain Punch, Dark Pulse, Gunk Shot, and Hyperspace Hole. That actually works out, in my opinion. Because you go for Drain Punch, you restore your health from the Life Orb recoil. It works. And then the HP investment is max HP and max special attack and 4 in attack. So there you have it. That's my team for UU. And I hope you guys enjoyed the battle. Alright, let's get to it. Alright, what is up YouTube? This is Trainer Connor. And we are here with a Wi-Fi battle video here. Which I already made the analysis video, or analysis portion of this video already, so I don't know if you skipped to this part or what, but anyways, yeah, so this is the battle. Quick rundown, in case you missed the analysis for some reason, we have a bulky Chandelure with Calm Mind, Shadow Ball, Flamethrower, and Pain Split, an Assault Vest, Hippowdon, a Leftovers, Mangabuzz, Offensive Alolan Ninetales, Choice Banded Cloyster. For some reason, I can't remember this Pokemon. That is so unorthodox. We have a Hoopa here, which has the Life Orb item. Pretty awesome, right? Pretty swell. My opponent has a Electabuzz, Torkoal, Empoleon, Togekiss, Nidoking, and Probopass. Alright, let's go ahead and play this thing. I'm going to start out with Hoopa here. And my opponent is going to begin with Probopass. So here, it's the first turn. Why not just go for the Drain Punch and just see what he's going to do. He's going to set up Steel Thrust, that's fine with me. I can always go into Mangabuzz and Defog those away if necessary. But he goes for Toxic. So that is a little unfortunate. Here I was thinking he might switch out, but that was a dumb decision, going for the hyperspace hole like that. He goes for his Stealth Rocks then. So if I were the Probopass, I would have probably set my Stealth Rocks and then go for Toxic. I don't know, but the way he played it on those first few turns were kind of weird, in my opinion. Anyways, we were able to take out Probopass, but that just means that Togekiss can come in and air slash me to death or something, but he goes for Psychic. I don't know why he did that. This will allow me to go with a Gunk Shot, which is very powerful coming from Hoopa, and it's super effective as well because Togekiss is a fairy type. He goes into Empoleon next, expecting another Gunk Shot, which I actually go for, which is really dumb. I really should have gone with a Drain Punch again or a Hyperspace Hole for coverage. Alas, I didn't do that, so therefore, my Hoopa goes down to the poison. That's not too bad. I can always go into Vulture, the Mangabuzz, and just go for the Defog. Get rid of those entry hazards from play, and in return, I get poisoned again. A lot of Pokemon getting poisoned today, folks. It's not one of those days, that's for sure. It's an easy day for me, but yesterday was really busy for me. I feel like I'm being poisoned to death. I don't know what I'm saying. But we get poisoned and we get hit by an Ice Beam. I'm not too worried about that because Mangabuzz has good special defense. whatsoever. So here I'm just trying to put some damage onto the Empoleon some more. This way I can go into my faster Pokemon that would take care of Empoleon. It's not like I have a lot of options. I don't have any electric type moves or anything that's, I guess, fighting type moves work against Empoleon. What I'm trying to say is I don't really have that much options against Empoleon, so we're doing the best we can here. I go for another knockoff as I keep rambling on, and we knock off a few items off. That is such a great sentence, you guys. I feel so sorry for that. Not really. But we get poisoned to death again. But that's not a big deal. Here I go for Stone Edge like a boss, and I miss. And that would have been awesome because I would have knocked out Torkoal. And I take a little bit of damage from the Earthquake, but not much. He goes back into Empoleon. So, yeah, we do have a few options against Empoleon, but I'm worried that Empoleon has Hydro Pump, and I would probably die on that. But he goes for Toxic again. I don't know what is up with my Pokemon getting poisoned all the time. I go for Fire Fang, trying to burn Empoleon for some reason. I really should have gone with an Earthquake, man. But that's not what we do here. He goes for Ice Beam. Again, I would have gone with a... Well, I mean, the sun is up, so I can't really complain, but you gotta do what you gotta do there to take care of a Hippowdon. But we take care of Empoleon there, which is pretty good. The sunlight fades, and now he gets to bring in Nidoking basically for free. I don't want him to kind of get that KO like that, so we end up going to Snowball, and we see a very interesting Nidoking set with Power Up Punch, and then I go for Psyshock. Over Ice Beam, I would probably go with Ice Beam. Yeah, very unfortunate. A plus one Poison Jab KOs my beautiful Snowball, and that really is just something I cannot do again. I got really lucky, and that kind of makes up for a few of my misses already with Stone Edge. And we get a Calm Mind boosted Flamethrower underneath our belt here, and we finish off Nidoking just like that. And then he goes into Togekiss. I will outspeed, but then I decide to switch out, which I don't know. I feel like I haven't used Cloyster yet. So, why not take advantage of that when I really should have just gone with a Flamethrower? I don't know. I try to be too cute with these decisions, you guys. Sometimes it happens and it works out, but sometimes it doesn't. Now, here is Electabuzz, who has not hit the battlefield yet. And so I just go for a Choice Banded Ice Shard there. And then he goes for the Charge Beam. He gets the boost from Charge Beam. And so that basically means I have to deal with a plus one Electabuzz. And because of the Assault Vest, I was able to live that plus one Psychic, and we finish off Electabuzz. Amazing. And we get a double down out of this. Let's make it more amazing. Yeah, let's do it. And so that leaves with just my Chandelure against Torkoal. And Torkoal can't really do much because I have Flash Fire as an ability, so I just go for a Calm Mind. And then he goes for the Flame Wheel, and that just steals the battle right there, folks. So he forfeits, but in the end, I would have won anyway because, you know, a plus one or a plus two Shadow Ball would have KO'd the Torkoal without the Assault Vest because he had that earlier, but I knocked it off. Anyways, that was a great battle, and I actually won for the first time in a long time, which is great. So, I hope you guys enjoyed this battle video. If you end up liking this video, subscribe. Well, I mean, like the video first, and then subscribe. Or you can do the opposite, I don't know. But I will be back here with another video coming. I'm going out of town this weekend, so no video then. Probably something next week. If not, then I'll probably try. I'll try putting something out before I leave for the weekend. But either way, I will see you in the next video. Have a great day, a great week, great weekend, great Labor Day weekend. I'll see you later. Bye now.